もしやコスモでは。
Cosmo needs me free.
Cosmo AP Luxury Sports.
Well, it's part 38 of my 76 Mazda Cosmo Restoration. And no, your eyes are not deceiving you, for I am now coming to you in high definition. For this episode, I'm going to do something a bit different and concentrate on one specific task, something that most people, I'd say, who have put an old car back on the road have had to deal with, and that is cleaning and sealing an old fuel tank. The tank's been chemically cleaned with super clean and water. So now I am just performing the old trick of rattling something like a chain or bearings or stones around in the tank to break off any rust. So while I'm here shaking my tank, why don't we just go back on some of the footage from the previous two episodes, which showed how I cleaned out the nasty gunk from the interior chemically.
Oh, that is not good. I can't even identify that. This is like buildup one would find on the belly of a prostitute. Except smells better and tastes better.
This tank is grody inside, just nasty. Needs a full cleaning and sealing.
I don't know if you can see that, but that black tar used to be gasoline. To try to dissolve some of the nasty that's in the tank, I'm going to use some super clean. I guess what I'll just do is pour it in full strength, slosh it around a little, and then maybe cut it with some water and let it sit.
Well, after shaking for a few minutes, the super clean has dislodged a ton of crap from the inside. So what I'm doing is filling it with warm water, and then I'm just gonna let it sit for days. God, all the baffles in this thing make it really difficult to empty out. That's kind of the point, though. I've flushed the tank a few times now with water, and the water is basically running clear, but I can still see that there's like a film inside the tank. So I'm going to pour the rest of the super clean in, swish it around a little, and then just let the stuff sit full strength for a few days.
Now, visiting the tank again, it seems that the pure super clean is removing the gunk and crap and whatever the hell that is from the bottom of the tank very effectively.
Oh, that is nasty. Yuck. Don't do that. Just giving it a few good rinsings with hot water to remove all the super clean and other residue. I'd say that's looking pretty clean at this point. If wrappers from Georgia are to be believed, two chains are better than one. Chain. the gym, shake a tank full of chains for an hour or two. Remember that the tank is baffled, so you gotta get the chain to all the different areas of the tank. Well, judging by the amount of rust that has come out of this tank, I'd say that made a big difference. But now, the trouble is getting the chains out. Guess that worked, because I'm sweeping up tank rust everywhere. I shook those chains for about an hour. I gotta say, my arms are killing me. I can skip the workout tonight. So I'm leaving the shop for the night, and I'm going to let it sit for another night with full strength super clean on the bottom, and then next time I'm here, I'll rinse it out, and then we can start the cleaning and sealing procedure. At this point, this is just rusty water, so it can go right down the drain. Obviously, if it was fuel residue, it would have to go to the hazardous waste depot. I'll be sealing the tank with POR-15's fuel tank sealing kit. And this is a three-step process consisting of their Marine Clean Cleaner Degreaser, the metal-ready MetalPrep to etch and dissolve rust, and then finally the sealer itself. And the most important part are the instructions. I've made sure to rinse all of the super clean thoroughly out of the tank, because we don't want to mix chemicals. So the first step is the cleaner degreaser, and it gets poured in, and then another quart of water mixed with it. It comes in a quart, so I'm just going to use the bottle to measure out the water. Once again, I'm rolling around a fuel tank because they say that they want every surface in this tank covered with this stuff for a minimum of 20 minutes. Because I need to be able to turn the tank upside down to completely coat all the surfaces, guess I'll have to seal all of these holes with duct tape. However, I do not think that is going to work very well. And now it has to sit with the cleaner covering each surface for 20 minutes. Thank you. minutes, about 20 minutes on each side. Now this tape, it didn't do a damn thing. Well, the instructions say that the tank at this point should be rinsed out, but this thing was dirtier than the underside of a Las Vegas prostitute. So I stopped at the hardware store, picked up a toilet brush, and then this flexible brush. So I'm going to spend a little bit of time scrubbing out the inside just as much as I can reach it. Because, hey, you know what? Can't hurt. I will not be able to reach every area of the tank with the brushes. But I do have another bottle of cleaner, so.
Am I cream pieing a fuel tank?
Scrub every area of the tank, but I got as much as I could. Now I guess it's time to rinse it out. Give it another good rinsing. Whoops. There's a lot of water in here. It's kind of heavy.
I gotta say, that's a pretty clean fuel tank.
They gave me a second bottle of the cleaner degreaser. So I'm just going to put this bottle into the tank and then fill the tank entirely with water and let it sit overnight before I continue. The instructions didn't mention the second bottle. I just assume that they put it in if you have a very large fuel tank, which I don't. The tank is now sat overnight. Full of water, it's kind of too heavy for one person to move. So I'm just going to siphon it out. And once again, it's rinse and repeat until all the traces of the cleaner are gone. Now it doesn't have to be dry for the next step, but I'm using the air gun to try to dry it out as much as possible. The next step in the process, just like many POR-15 products, is to etch the entire surface of the inside of the tank with the MetalPrep, used to be called Metal Ready. Now the instructions say that this needs to coat every surface of the tank for a minimum of 20 minutes, with a maximum of 2 hours. So what that means is another bout of rolling the tank around and coming back to it every few minutes. Well, I don't have a lot of faith in this tape holding this time either, but it only has to hold so I can briefly turn this thing upside down and rotate and not spill tons of fluid. So here we go. Oh, not bad. And I have 2 more hours of that to look forward to. Every time I agitate this thing, I try to leave it in a different position to sit for a few minutes. I've been rolling this thing around now for about 2 hours. So the metal prep, which I believe is mostly phosphoric acid, has likely done its job. Time for the next step. And you can see how the phosphoric acid in the metal prep has removed all of the surface rust and left a zinc phosphate coating. Yep. More bloody rinsing. The whole tank needs to be rinsed out with very warm water. Yes, the instructions actually say very warm. This tank better be springtime fresh after this much douching. Seriously, how much footage is there of me shaking this fuel tank around? It's taken a lot of rinsings to get all the metal prep out of this tank, but it has to all be removed, otherwise it's going to form sort of a white powder, which means the sealer won't adhere. And if you do this, I highly recommend you don't do it, for example, over the new living room carpet. And it's been rinsed about 15 times, so I'm just trying to shake the last little bit of water out of it where I have some room and where it doesn't matter if I get things wet. I'm trying to dry it out as quickly as possible to minimize the amount of flash rust. Heat gun. Is this unsafe? Now see these instructions? If the camera can focus, tank must be completely dry. So even though it's going to sit at least overnight before I put the sealer in, I'm going to make sure this thing is bone freaking dry. It's the key to many POR-15 products. The heat gun worked way better than the compressed air. This thing is completely dry inside. And in fact, the whole tank has been raised to a temperature where I can't touch it. The tank has now sat overnight and appears to be 100% completely, totally bone dry. Now I'm just using a bit of compressed air to blow some of the white phosphate powder that can sometimes accumulate when you use the metal prep slash metal ready. I'm just blowing off the excess so that it won't adhere with paint adhesion. This isn't in the instructions, but it's something that I've had to do in the past when using POR-15 stuff. Okay, about 10 minutes of blowing through all the holes I could find, and there's no more white stuff coming out. That's obviously what she said. So I think it's probably ready to coat. It stands to reason that the paint is designed to probably deal with some of the white phosphor powder, but I just wanted to remove all the excess. Putting the screws back in for the fuel sender to seal up the holes before I clog them up with sealant. I can always get new screws, but it was a major pain in the ass to have to clean out these threads. Yep, taping up my holes again, but for the last time. Well, this is what it's all leading up to, the actual sealer itself. I've reread the instructions. It's just a matter of opening the can. Yeah. Then stirring it up. I bent some welding wire into a handy little stirrer. This smells almost exactly like POR-15. Made me a quick and dirty paper funnel. Well, the next step is to pour it in, and I'm gonna make a mess. Surprisingly, very little mess, or no mess made, which is very rare when using a POR-15 product. And to coat the tank, it just gets slowly rolled around. And I gather it's done very slowly so that the coating doesn't become aerated. It's pretty thick, so it shouldn't ooze out of the tape. I'm not really worried about that. So I'm going to be probably doing this for about 10 minutes. This is almost like some type of meditation-based fuel tank Tai Chi. I've been turning this thing over and over for about 10 minutes. I'd say that's plenty to coat the tank and all the baffles. This tank is really well baffled. Time to drain the excess. Well, there's a lot less going out than went in. That's a good sign. Well, I'm going to call that as empty as she's gonna get. Looks like just over a quarter can of sealant ended up in the tank. Now I have no frame of reference, but that seems pretty good to me. Well, time to take all the tape off so this thing can begin drying. I'd imagine, like all POR-15 products, Once this is on your skin, it's permanent. This has to dry for 96 hours. So I am just going to leave it on the longest edge of the tank so that the seams are horizontal. Only because if there's any extra sealant in there, I don't want it collecting in the seams because it'll never dry. Instead, I'd rather have it flatten out over the long horizontal area. Okay, now the wait, 3 days. The tank has now dried for 96 hours, as specified by the instructions, and thankfully, these screws still come out. I am gonna call this a success. That is a well-coated tank. It is extraordinarily difficult to get a shot of this. The coating has completely sealed the inside of the tank and laid down pretty smooth considering. Now the inside is shiny and clean, so I might as well make the outside shiny and clean. Just giving it a quick spritz with some of the brake cleaner so I can clean it off and give it a quick paint job. I'm going to paint the outside of the tank in black POR-15, but since the tank isn't rusty bare metal, I'm just scrubbing the existing paint down with a Scotch-Brite to kind of break the glaze, and I will just paint over what's already here. Scotch-Brite wasn't cutting fast enough, so I went to 80 grit sandpaper. That seems to be making a right mess of it. And one last scrub with a little bit of brake cleaner to remove the sanding debris. Just mixing up a little bit of POR-15 rust paint in semi-gloss black. Now I'm going to spray this, so I added a little bit of POR-15 solvent to thin it out just a tad.
Painted! First coat.
Second and final coat, mixed a bit thicker this time. Well, considering this was just a quick scuff and shoot, that tank came out as well as it needed to. This point, just a matter of removing all the masking tape, then it can be reassembled and put back in the car. Connect the fuel lines. And that's one fully refurbished fuel tank. So I guess that means we're done. What's next? I don't know. Well, I guess I've been putting it off long enough, so it's probably time to tackle that front subframe and suspension.